I think the Shintala album is a celebration of five old friends coming together and a new one joining us. It's been great to have Simon join the band, and it's been great to have all five of the original members of Shintala come back.
It's different. There's a lot of new tunes in there and different styles of music. I think everybody is 5 years older and wiser than when we last played together, and we've added Simon to the group. There's a different feel to the band, I think. And it's come together nicely, this album. There's a lot of material which rocks, I would say. And the atmosphere has been good in the studio. We've sourced stuff from all kinds of different places. We have original compositions. There's a different feel to it. There's a kind of a mixture of Irish, Scottish, and I would say North American kind of feel to this album. There's a few tunes in there which could easily have come from Appalachia or from Canada or from the Cajun country. We've got several guests on. We have Didgeridoo on this album, which is interesting. I think it reflects the fact that the five of us have been off playing with other people for the last few years. So for me, it's out of the three Shintala albums, this is definitely as good as either of the other two, and it could easily be our best album.
All of the songs on the Shintala album, this one, are songs that I love to sing. We have a nice mix of up-tempo and heartbroken songs, as well as a couple of happier songs. Some of the songs that I brought to the band, but there's two that I worked together with Simon. One in a lovely afternoon in Antwerp over a couple of bollocks, and the other one he found from his research. Two songs that are new compositions. One is by C. Khan, What You Do With What You've Got. I picked that one because I loved the words and the message behind it. The second song I chose was by Karen Polwart, just because even though it was written several years ago about the woman of Srebrenica, it's still really, really valid today, and it reaches out and touches your heart. So I love that song.
One word that springs to mind for the Shintala sound is powerful. It's always been a powerful sound, and it's even more powerful now with six of us. There's a lot going on there. You've got lead instruments, you've got accordion, you've got flutes, ilan pipes, a fiddle, and as backing you've got Bowron bouzouki guitar, and on the faster pieces it gives you that extra sixth gear that you might need from time to time, and it also gives you the options of being very subtle on some of the slower things. You can change instruments. I think there are some Irish bands where track 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the instrumentation's all the same, whereas with us we have the firepower, if you like, and the variety to be able to change things around, and track 1 can sound completely different to track 2 or 3. So I think that's one of the things about Shintala that makes it interesting and unique.
We've got three backing vocalists on the CD, which is really nice because I used to do most of the backing vocals myself. Very, very different. We've got two young girls, Hannah and Megan Murray, Jerry's daughters, who sing beautiful backing vocals on Where Do You Lie. And I like the fact that it's two young girls because it brings a really female feel to the song, and they're also completely different vocalists to me, so that makes it a lovely difference to the song. And we were also lucky enough to have Luca Aubrey from Iliana come and join us and do some didgeridoo, some amazing mouth singing. I don't know how he does it, I have to see him do it live, and some backing vocals also. So it gives a good depth of interest to the songs that you don't always have when you sing it yourself.
I think anybody who comes to see a Shintala show is going to get, if they've seen us before, they'll get what they were expecting, and they'll get a lot of drive, a lot of power, a lot of humour, and some very good music. Who knows, it took us 8 years to make this CD because we took a break. Hopefully it won't be that long before the next one comes out, but we'll see. We're still gathering material, and we're still all very active. It'd be nice to make another CD sometime in the next couple of years.
The future's bright, I think the future's really bright. We're all a bit older, we're all a bit wiser. We all appreciate what Shantala brings to us, whereas before we kind of went along with it and we enjoyed it, but now coming back to it, you can look at it and really think, you know what, this is good, I like it, and we're going to keep it going.
In fact, I think this album is probably the most original of the three albums that we've made with Shantala, and personally I really like the material on this album.
Really, really hope you enjoy listening to it as much as we enjoyed making it, and looking forward to hear you sing along with the vocals.
Por delay my vida, por delay my son, por delay my angel long. When will